your PhD program. You have very good examples of what can be done. So please ask the question. Even in Cambodian, if you're shy in English, you can ask in Cambodian, it will be translated and shown by the speakers.
This is a question for the first presentation about the doctoral program that you are putting into place on sustainable
resource management in Batamba. I see that you included in the project $1,500 of fees. How is this financed only by the students? There are grants possibilities or they must pay from their private money?
Thank you for your question. For $1,500 per year is not the grant, but the student must pay to the university. We have the scholarship for the PhD student, so only 1 month mobility to Europe. This is the grant that we can provide to PhD candidate.
Thank you for the question. Even we charge 1,500 because we want to contribute to our administrative fee like electricity, water, or classroom. Even we get the grant like fund from EU, like lecturer or another researcher come to UPP, but we need to charge. Because we discuss with our committee member, also with our top management, we decide to charge like this. Also, we think this field is expensive if compared with another school in Cambodia. $1,500 for a 3-year program. We expect some students cannot finish 3 years, it can be more than 3 years, 4 or 5 years. And then we try our best to find some financial support to help our students in this program. To make sure that they can succeed the PhD program in this project. Thank you.
Another question? So I perhaps have, oh yes?
Good afternoon, my name is Jimmy from IUA. I'd like to ask to our delegate speakers from UPB. First thing, I appreciate because you have done many things. Yeah. Until now, you have many programs already for master degree and doctoral degree. And in terms of doctoral, the students for the master degree and the PhD, in case they pay by their own, then while they are ongoing students, how is it possible for them to apply or any scholarship that they can apply for at the same time while they are already, for example, like the second or the third semester, for example. And I saw with Miss that you have presented about the sponsors. And with the collaboration, isn't it that the candidates they can apply for the scholarship? Or is it the support with collaboration with the UPE? Thank you.
Thank you for your question. Regarding the scholarship, as I mentioned, we can provide from the project, the Bongsi project, we can provide 1 month mobility for every PhD candidate to Europe. But after that, they can, if their performance, if their performance is good enough, their supervisor in Europe can extend their mobility by finding other funds in level left in their left or other funds from, for example, from the embassy, from England, Erasmus Plus, K1, etc.
My name is Vutha from the University of Hong Kong and one of the scientific coordinator of the program. I just wanted in terms of the scholarship, actually we have like a 1 month mobility for master or PhD student in Europe. But I think I remember for the budget we can fund between 2 to 4. Next week we will have a meeting on the project in Europe. That we will talk about for some outstanding candidate, we may look at some fund to extend from 1 month to 6 months. It depends on the performance of the candidate because if they are doing good, we will look at the fund to support them. So next week, we will talk with all our partners and then look at how to apply for project that is in our proposal to support more funding for the candidate beyond the budget, because the budget approved for only 1 month. I think I remember it's 2 or 4 candidates. So from next week, we hope that we have some more information because we want for them to stay longer if they are doing good. So we, all the partners, will look at a very opportunity to apply for the other project to fund the mobility in Europe.
Thank you very much. Any more questions? Yes. Denmark.
It might be a general question for all of the Cambodian partners if we answer this question. I'm thinking that whether there is any funding from Ministry of Education to send your PhD student to Europe, maybe for 1 year or 3 years. Is there any funding for that from the government?
From MoEYS, in the case of Royal University of Agriculture, we have not received any funding from the Ministry of Education from our government. Most of the case that we experience is if the topic, research topic of the doctoral student, the research topic is interesting, normally we could grab the grant, the research grant and also the tuition fee grant from different partners, donors, like NGOs. For instance, yesterday the USAID granted 5 research grants for doing research and the whole 3 years doctoral course program tuition fee. So mostly we are receiving the grant from international organization, non-government organization, but not from the Ministry of Education yet. But I don't know for other university like UVB or other university ever received it or not. Thank you.
So this is same for the colleague as well who are working as a lecturer or assistant professor in any Cambodian university, they might need a PhD degree from European university. Do they have a special funding from those group of the people from the government?
Yeah, they provide. Those who are from government sector who enroll in our doctoral program and doing research, they try to grab the grant for doing the fund for research fund and also the tuition fee grant. And of course, many of them could get from international, non-governmental international organization for other project. Sometimes they work together, the project from other countries, they have projects, conduct study or research in Cambodia. And they would love the government officers to strengthen their capability on doing research and to work on the research in their project. So they fund all the doctoral research and tuition. for them to do research and study the doctoral degree. And that's very benefit, mutual benefit for both sides. That's very good as well. Okay, I would like to share something about the fund, the support from the government side. Actually, previously, the government thinks to short to send students, send elite or send potential students abroad to do the graduate training. On even though on the master program, operational program, and I think the situation now, yes, the change to new phase that perhaps the decision maker think that we have enough sufficient human resource to do doctoral, to run doctoral program by our own. So that's why the minister and Yves here is working on this very hard. And for now, we have the law from the World Bank and something else from other sources. They also promote the research area, the research activity. And this we will need to have PhD and master training individually.
Yes, even though the government not support for NSR, not providing for NSR support to send over regional to study in abroad, but the government on the way, my support, I went to study, I did my PhD in Malaysia for 4 years, and then my government keep my position and also keep my salary. It is a deliberate policy to promote our active members to study abroad. Last time they don't provide anything. They reduce the salary to half. But now they keep on even position the whole salary to keep on. Not cut anymore. Thank you.
With this financial system, more in each doctoral school, we must imagine internal rule and regulation. But sure, we speak about that. We hope that some funds will come from national budget. But that is not easy because, you know, I am not a specialist of this point because I am not Indian. But in fact, in the Ministry of Education, we have no money. All the money is in the Ministry of Economy and Finance. We have a budget at the beginning of year, but after, for each project, for each action, we must ask a second acceptation, a second agreement of MoEYS. Some day ago, we have His Excellency Rational accept a PhD program. So the agreement of ministry was given, but after Ministry of Finance said no. So it's not always easy, and it's not easy for me to answer now.
Can I say something?
To me, this gentleman raised a very good point. But to me, I think regarding the hierarchy or the structural organization of the Mongolian Science Open Committee, Mongolian Science Committee for research or something, doctoral school or something, yeah. And the graduate school in each university. This is a matter of negotiation at the top level, right? I think we will just accept to do research and for the patient building for quality research. This is what our level should think of. I mean, as a graduate school level or scientists or researchers. For the matter of finance, just be simple and plain. We don't care about finance. What we care is the science and the research. that we need to train students, doctoral students, to train to upgrade their capability to create a very good system for the country. So if I have no idea about how finance should be conducted, should go, but I think the European country has a good system for finance. So as long as we have a very good system to do research, have a human resource and everything, we don't need to worry about it. Let other people who are skilled, the skilled people in finance and governance, that's all. We don't need to care. That's my viewpoint. Thank you.
There's no question from the room. I wanted to ask, is there any cooperation to expect as well from the new system? I mean, for the time being, perhaps the university competing with their doctoral programs individually. Do you think it may increase cooperation between the university, the Cambodian universities, somehow with the
leader? RDC has a frontier, and we also be a member of MoEYS 7, I think, Indonesia, including top university of Cambodia. This is a channel that we can cooperate inside us. And RDC tries to extend our partnership with universities from, especially in the region, since Asian integration is close, very much closer to us. We have to be ready to attract the investors, also to build up our capacity to work in the demanding field. And we will support our network in developing a program which support IDP. Mean that IDP is the industrial development policy of the Royal Government of Cambodia. Okay. And yes, we try to extend at the maximum as we can to work with the partners and under the full framework.
Now the discussion, what I understood from the panel is that you have the right ideas about what would be the future of this doctoral school, and you have been initiatives that have been taken so far and that are quite successful and serve as a model, not only taking external model but internal model to develop the doctoral schools in Cambodia. I understood as well that money should not be a problem and research the main motivation. From the university point of view, but from the student as well, should be motivated to do some research and to be passionate for an idea, subject, or topic. And so, the future perhaps will be bright for Cambodia because of that. So, thank you very much, all the participants. And